A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 16 December, on the front page you have violence hits Delhi over citizenship law. So police had to resort to tear gas, lathi charge to block protesters near Jamia Millia Islamia. Even the protesters set buses on fire. So we have seen protests going on in Assam and other states, even in West Bengal. And now here in Delhi, it has turned violent. Then this is no deal as long as longest climate talks end. So this is regarding the climate summit, which went on for more than 12 days. Two more days were added to the 12 days of the scheduled talks in Madrid, Spain. So this was the conference of parties for UN Framework Convention on Climate Change. So in this, delegates from almost 200 countries endorsed a declaration to help poor countries that are suffering the effects of climate change, but they did not allocate any new funds to do so. So the talks have ended now, but the major polluters resisted calls to ramp up efforts to keep global warming at bay, and they postponed the regulation of global carbon markets until next year now. Then below you have UK raised concerns over BJP affiliates' support to conservatives. So British diplomat met BJP's foreign cell head in Delhi because it was alleged that BJP members were supporting Labour MPs. That he had identified 48 marginal-led seats where Indian diaspora would make a difference. And he persuaded voters to vote for Conservative Party was supporting Mr. Johnson, Boris Johnson, from the Conservative Party for becoming the UK Prime Minister. So this, you can see, support in the elections. There were Indian origin MPs, which was Indian origin candidates, which were standing as for contesting the post for MPs. They were from Labour Party, but support was mobilized for the Conservative candidates instead by BJP affiliates. So this is a concern being raised now by UK. And this is regarding FASTag. Though FASTag has become mandatory and still 25% lanes are reserved for cash transactions, but you can see FASTag lanes are empty and further crowding at select lines has seen cash only lines. And this is RTI case. Center files affidavit in sealed cover. So Supreme Court is to hear the case on continuing vacancies at Central and State Information Commissions. And in this case, central government has filed its progress report in sealed covers. So the commissions are the court of appeal, means under the RTI Act, if there are problems in getting information under the RTI Act or in any other way, the commissions have to be approached. So the continuing vacancies, of course, lead to long delays in settling of cases. So the Supreme Court is hearing this case. At Central Information Commission, there are 4 vacancies and there are 33,000 pending cases. So Supreme Court had issued a show cause notice to the center and the governments of states where appointments have not taken place. And central government gave its reply in a sealed cover. On page 5, you have maternity scheme exclusionary, need benefits for all. So this is regarding the maternity scheme which has been launched by the central government, which is called Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana. So it was announced 3 years ago in 2016, on 31st December 2016. But 5 months later, when the Union Cabinet approved the scheme, it decided to give benefit of 5,000 rupees to pregnant and lactating mothers for the birth of the first child. So this would be disbursed in 3 installments upon meeting several conditionalities like registration of pregnancy, at least 1 antenatal checkup, registration of childbirth and vaccinations. So the remaining cash incentive of up to 1,000 is to be given as under a separate scheme which is called the Janani Suraksha Yojana. So that an average woman gets a total sum of 6,000 rupees. So the objective of this scheme was to compensate women for wage loss during childbirth. But activists say that registration for the scheme requires an applicant to provide husband's Aadhaar details along with her. So single women, which include unwed mothers, deserted wives and widows, so they are not able to avail the scheme. So that's why it's called an exclusionary scheme. So mother seeking benefits needs to provide address of a marital home. So, which proves challenging for a newlywed expecting a child and often residing in her natal home during pregnancy. So then she is forced to go from pillar to post to claim benefits. So these are the concerns being raised in these schemes. On page 6, you have three Odisha students develop smart water dispenser. So these are students from Odisha Kendriya Vidyalaya. They have developed a smart water dispenser to ensure equal distribution of drinking water through pipelines in any urban or rural habitat to combat future water crisis. So here you can see they are in Sochi in Russia, the three students with the idea of smart water dispenser. On page 7, you have pending dues, visitor centers at Ajanta Ellora shut. So Ajanta Ellora, which are UNESCO World Heritage Sites, there were two tourist visitor centers set up at these caves by Maharashtra government with funding from Japan's JICA, that is Japanese International Cooperation Agency. So these two visitor centers have been shut down due to their pending water and electricity dues worth 5 crore rupees. So centers were supposed to serve as one-stop location for all information about history and importance of these UNESCO heritage sites. They had some replica structures also, replica sculptures located inside the caves. Replicas of sculptures located inside the caves in these centers. So they were set up, you can see, in 2013 for 125 crore rupees, which was provided by, a major part of it was provided by JICA. But now it is shut. It is shut because of water and electricity bills not paid. On page 8, you have 21 days not enough for probe into rape cases, says National Commission for Women Chief. So this time frame of 21 days which have been given to the police to complete investigation and the courts to convict the accused in rape case under the new Disha Act of Andhra Pradesh government has been called by National Commission for Women as too lesser time. States must adopt a realistic stance for concrete results and not fan sentiments. On page 9, you have chaos in toll plazas over fast tag rollouts. So, fast tag rollout, which we saw on front page 2, has started, but rush is at cash only. So several booths hit by congestion. But many vehicles also had RFID stickers, but then the sufficient balance was insufficient. And this is officials skeptical of making 45 Vande Bharat rakes in 2 years. So Railway Ministry has cleared the decks for Integral Coach Factory to make Vande Bharat Express trains. But then officials are skeptical that 45 rakes will be ready by in 2 years. So even if tenders are floated immediately as per revised specifications approved by RDSO, Research Design and Standards Organization, it would still take at least 2 years to roll out the first prototype for operation. And then the mandatory oscillation tests and safety approvals would be done. And then you can see mass production can take place. On the editorial page, the first editorial is many mutinies. So this is regarding the protests against Citizenship Amendment Act. So this has opened up old fault lines in Northeast too, where major protests are taking place against the bill, because those are the states where regions where the bill would mostly affect, and many states have been excluded, those which are under the 6th schedule, Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura, Mizoram. So some parts of Assam and Tripura are still part of it, are still there, excluded from exemptions. And then you have even the states with inner line permits, which are excluded, northeastern states. So this is that. And the second editorial is probing the police. So this is regarding the judicial inquiry into rape suspects killing. So it says this should not undermine the criminal probe. So criminal investigation would also take place in this. A judicial inquiry has been initiated. The lead article is the distinct cry of an imperiled frontier. So this is regarding the Citizenship Amendment Act again. So it says the rest of India must recognize the concerns of the Northeast in what it sees in the Citizenship Amendment Act. So this article clearly states why Northeast is protesting against the act. because it is going to affect the population distribution there, and the indigenous people would be marginalized because these are border states, and from Bangladesh majorly the people from Bangladesh settle down in these states only. They have to preserve their language, their culture, which would be affected by this Citizenship Amendment Act. And this is spot the difference between sign and symbol. So this is regarding the lotus symbol, so which is there on the passports now, new passports. So it's symbol of BJP political party too. Palm is the symbol of Congress. So are not just political marks, it says just as the lion and the wheel, and are not just Buddhist representations. So lotus and palm are not just political marks, is what this article tries to say, and lion and wheel are not just Buddhist representations, which are part of the national symbols. On opposite page you have this coverage on Brexit after the elections in UK, where Boris Johnson's Conservative Party got a comfortable majority. So it says in Britain there's a lot to get done. So Boris Johnson's Brexit slogan has won him a majority, but the road ahead is full of challenges because he has to negotiate a deal with European Union and get it approved by Parliament. So that's the way ahead. But this was his poll campaigning, get Brexit done. Then on page 12 you have here delay in sending official notifications to Parliament. So government is delaying tabling of key notifications to Parliament, thereby withholding information that should be available to all members. So this is study by a parliamentary panel which has revealed that out of 233 statutory notifications containing rules and regulations from 14 ministries, 125 notifications were presented to Parliament after a delay ranging from 1 to 10 months. So notifications are required to be laid on the table of the House within 15 days of their publication in the Gazette, if the House is in session, if not within 15 days of the commencement of the next session. But serious delays are taking place in laying down notifications before the Parliament. And here also, this is DMK protesting against the Citizenship Amendment Act, saying are Sri Lankan Tamils not Hindus, because there Hindus have not been allowed to enter into the country. So BJP using citizenship law to deflect focus from pressing issues, he says. On page 13 you have pleas in Supreme Court speak of past judgments. So a dozen petitions have been filed against Citizenship Amendment Act of 2019, and they trace a series of Supreme Court judgments in which the court stood up for the dignity of the individual against the tyranny of the majority. So these Constitution Bench judgments, which range from decriminalization of homosexuality to striking down triple talaq, hold that the state cannot discriminate on the basis of intrinsic and core identity of an individual. So being Muslim is part of person's core identity and dignity. It cannot be the basis for discrimination for granting citizenship, is what these petitions say in the Supreme Court. On international page you have this about Hong Kong and Brexit goes on almost every day. We don't need to cover it every day. Here you have rebels kill 22 in Congo in latest massacre. So these are Islamist rebels who hacked to death at least 22 civilians, including 13 women, in an overnight raid in Congo's Democratic Republic of Congo's troubled Beni region, which is bordering Uganda. And then here you have Jamaica's Tony Ann Singh bags Miss World title. So here you can see. Miss Universe was announced recently, now this is Miss World. And this is Turkey to sign off on military pledge to Libya. So Turkey has moved closer to military support for Libya's internationally recognized government with a bilateral deal that provides for a quick reaction force if requested by Libya to be sent as such. So this has been sent to Parliament now, so of Turkey. So Egypt has warned against interference in Libya now. Tripoli is the capital of Libya. Then on Mondays you have MoneyWise coverage on business page. So that's not important. and the last page has sports related news. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.